many treasure you'll find out here.
Almost.
And there's something to be writing it out. There's
it's
something
almost
physical
easier,
about
sir.
It.
On the continent, and this is the same speed of assembly freedom of movement. Commander-in-Chief President Washington had a saying, the best way to be resolved.
Thank you.
quick right off the wall.
Thank you. getting all of the equipment from 3rd Brigade off of these vessels and loading it out here onto the port so we can push it onto Poland in order to support 3rd Brigade operations to really increase our presence in the European front. All right, well, we're showing cooperation with our friendly NATO allies. We're going to work with the Polish Army as well as the Lithuanian and Latvian Army throughout our time here. I've been here for 2 days. We're on the torch flight, so we were the first people from 3rd Brigade to land. Got here 2 days ago and are just now starting our port operations. Well, I mean, it seems generally kind of the same like the United States, but we, you know, obviously the metric system is different, but I've been here once before and I really have gotten accustomed to the same type of living. Everything's kind of smaller, I guess. They got the small vehicles, but nothing too far different than the U.S. I like it a lot. It's a great country, beautiful country. So I serve as the company unit movement officer. I'm in charge of making sure all of our equipment gets put on the trains, which happened back at Fort Carson. Then they moved to Beaumont, Texas. And from Beaumont, Texas, they got loaded onto these vessels here. Then from Beaumont, Texas, here to Bremerhaven, and they're going to be unloaded here at the port and pushed to the railhead here and then all the way to Poland. So different battalions are doing convoys. 1-8 is going to be convoying from here to their final destination. My battalion is going to be putting it on trains and then picking it up in Poland. So the convoys will be pretty well organized. They're leaving straight from here. I know 1-8 brought a lot of people so they can man all their vehicles and push them farther. We're going to pick up our vehicles in Poland. I'm the only one from my company here to make sure everything gets put on the train, and then our drivers will meet the vehicles in Poland and pick it up, drive it to our final compound.
So I mostly am a truck mechanic, which in titles that I work on 88s and 113s. But like I said, I'm cross-trained on wheel vehicles as well. And pretty much my role in all this is just to make sure that our vehicles aren't ate up, like they run the way they're supposed to, they're not going to break down on a field problem, or, you know, we're trying to show that we've got some of the best equipment in the world, so we don't want to take something off the boat and then it just blows up on us, or everything just shuts down and stops working. So I'm there to make sure that that doesn't happen. So far, what I've seen is that our equipment is, I mean, it took a lot of work and there's some rough patches, but our equipment's coming out here looking really good. Everything's starting the way it's supposed to, everything's running the way it's supposed to. But the cold weather's not too good for the equipment right now because it's a lot different climate over here. But like our vehicles are acclimating to it and they're running the way they're supposed to. Oh yeah, so I haven't like had too much contact with the contractors, but they're getting our vehicles off efficiently. They're parking them up for us, and then we're just running just a few checks on them, making sure all the batteries are hooked up so the vehicles are ready to get started. And alright, so I plan on doing it for a long time, at least 20 years. So I'm very excited about this deployment. I've heard Europe's beautiful, which so far it seems like it. I mean, the base is a little creepy, but yeah, it's nice. Like, I'm super excited to be out here, and yeah, I just hope I get more deployments like this one because everybody's so friendly. Like, I don't speak German. So it's been hard to communicate with some of the people that I run into or that I like try to converse with me. But yeah, it's been cool. I like it.